How about a big iHeartRadio welcome for John, Adam, Sean, and Mark, Taking Back Sunday. Let's go.
I took my time, I held my tongue, knew all along you were the one. I didn't buy, 'cause you were the one. Oh, well, I'm better off for better. I'd be better off for getting it. Go big or go home. If I that little bit of time you said you needed then.
Melissa made this strap for me.
That's a sick strap.
So you're standing on the corner, you were waiting for me. It must have been past midnight. Started thinking to myself, it's been a bad couple years. Soon everything will be alright. The moon shines down on amphetamine smiles. We finally got some time to kill. He asked if I could make the best of these bad decisions. I can't and I will. Came up, it meant so much, we don't remember what. You better save yourself before you try and save somebody else. Now this is all you have, a moment that you won't remember. You better save yourself before you try and save somebody. Oh, I drunk a star with a smile on her face. Then she told me not to take the pills. Said, girl, you got no faith in medicine. Oh, girl, you have no faith in medicine. You lack no other love. You lack no other. I'ma love you cause no other can. Talked until the sun came up. It's so much we don't remember. Save yourself before you try and save somebody else.
Wow, wow. Taking Back Sunday, everybody. This is our iHeartRadio album release party for their album 152, and I am Ted Stryker. Use the hashtag as you guys are watching at home, iHeart Taking Back Sunday. Adam, I got to go to you first, please. I just want to say, you guys are great. Jeez Louise.
Oh, shucks. Thank you, sir.
I mean, you deserve to be doing this as long as you have. I saw you all those years ago, and you're not only just as good as you were, it's like it sounds even better, so congrats to all the guys.
Thank you so much for saying that. Thank you.
What is it like, and how is it in 2023 when you give up 10 of your songs for everybody to hear and absorb and potentially critique compared to the previous albums?
Well, it's there's we don't listen to much of that chatter. I don't think I actually have this thing like I didn't know how, even how people were receiving the record really, just because I have to call Sean and ask him. I'm like, yeah, are people being cool on the internet? And and he'll be like, yeah. And this time it's just been yeses across the board. You can't really argue with them.
Good. 152 has been on the previous album. Sometimes it's been easy to see on the cover, but it's getting top billing. Why? Why top billing on this album?
Because we already had a self-titled record. No.
That's
a short
answer.
Yeah. So 152 is this, it's been on the cover of every one of our records, and it's this exit, it's on, there's this spot in North Carolina, that's where I come from, and then Interstate 40, Interstate 85, they merge, they come together, it's like Voltron, it's great. And then there's this exit on there. I grew up in a small town, we had to go there, and that's where we would meet, and it's been like a thing, like a secret, inside joke with our friends and us, you know, all these years. But then now, we figured, what better time, because we spent all this time trying to get into other people's lives, get into their world. And you know what? We want to invite folks to ours. Because right. We built a magnificent house, ladies and gentlemen. It's beautiful. And we'd love for you to come over. So it's an invitation. So now we figure rather than take it something that's just between our friends and us, like it's for everybody. And right. You know, hopefully you can stop by. That's what we think.
Yes, I like that. Instant connection. It gets bigger and bigger. As we sit here right now, what year did you guys start working on this new album?
We started working on it in 2019.
Whoa.
And the
2019?
Yeah, 2020, late 2019, early 2020. Actually, one of the sessions we got together for in Charlotte, the week after was when everything started going into lockdown for the pandemic. And the way that we work on songs is we all get together in a room and kind of react to each other's ideas and, you know, talk it through. And so once that was not an option, that whole kind of 2020, some of 2021 even, was just not an option to keep working on the record. So we picked it back up, you know, a year plus later, and actually listened to some of the stuff that we had done in 2020 and heard it as almost like someone else made it. It was like, wow, this is interesting. I don't remember that at all.
There's like a really early demo, and there was a song in the chorus was like, it is what it is, ain't what it is.
It's not what it is.
Just because we were like, do we know how to do this? I don't know.
Did you find yourselves tinkering with the songs more than normal, or was it like, nope, this one's done, here we go, moving on?
Oh, there was a lot of tinkering. We had a lot of time to work on the songs in between tours and stuff, which was part of coming back from the pandemic. We had to hit the road, we had to tour a lot, but we also got pretty good at writing on the road too, which is something we hadn't really done before. Usually days off were just days off. Went to our friend's studio in Buffalo, our friends in the Maine have a studio in Arizona, so we were able to hit those spots and write some cool songs in a really short amount of time and then revisit them later, so plenty of tinkering.
Your answer was so good. I just may stay with you, and you look great. Yeah. This is that's amazing.
He's the most reliable member.
Yeah, there's a reason why Sean Cooper's the most reliable member of our band.
You want more music? Let's get to it. Okay, thank you guys for watching. It is Stryker, hashtag iHeart Taken Back Sunday. It's our iHeart album release party for their latest 152. And once again, here's Taken Back Sunday.
You're gonna get so old, you're gonna get so old either way. Well, I was out of luck, I'll be conjecting. You should have been up to have me stay.
You gotta get so old. You gotta get so old. Either way.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you for letting us share that with you. That's just fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for that. It just feels good. There's like... Okay, so only one of those we've never played for anyone before, so thanks for that. There was... We were thinking, what better way to do it than something that's filmed live?
Perfect.
Yes! But we're killing it, so... If it ain't broke... I mean, I think so. You don't have to agree. You do you, I'll do me. Let's have a good time. All right.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Well, good talk. See you, everybody.
You've got this new head filled up with smoke, and I got my veins all tangled close. Through the jukebox bars you frequent, the safest place to hide. A long night spent with your most obvious weakness, you start shaking at that thought. You are everything I want, 'cause you are everything I am not.
That was so good, you guys. You played the new one, Sold. And to make damn sure, wow, the new album is called 152. They are Taking Back Sunday. I would be Ted Stryker. I would like to throw something at you, hopefully not embarrass you. 17 years ago, you wrote me a very nice note, and it had such a positive impact on me that I have kept it on my wall all these years.
No.
There it is from 2006, right there. I learned so much that little gesture can mean so much to somebody, and it's like, I really, really appreciate that, man. Thank you.
Hey, man, we appreciate you, too. Still, thank you very much. Crazy.
So my question to you is, when you were starting out, who are some bands out there that just treated you so great? You're like, I like that.
Oh, man.
makes it sound like there weren't any.
No. There's like so many, and then I'm like, because they're like, first band that really took us kind of under their wing, we did this Victory Records tour, and we were opening. We were like one of like 27 or however many people were on the bill. And then it was this band called Reach the Sky, and then who later two members went on, and they were in a band called Bane. But they were the like first ones to really like kind of be like, all right, kids, can't act this way. And then after that, it's like Lawrence Arms was huge.
Nice.
That was a huge thing for us. So those are the first two bands that we really had this experience. And Rival Schools too. We played this show with Rival Schools in Augusta, Georgia, or Athens, Georgia, at the 40 Watt Club, and there was a case of beer in the dressing room, and we saw it in there like, oh man, somebody left their beer. And then later our buddy Neil came by. He's like, you know that's for you, right? And then we're like, what? 12 beers for free? It's like, should we like leave money somewhere? They're like, no, you have them. We're like, does this happen all the time? So anyways, that's another band.
Yeah. Let's talk about new music again. John, I'll go to you on this. True or not true that the goal of the new songs that you released, the album is out, of course, mm-hmm. Was to get the songs played at weddings. Yes or no on that?
Yes, that was the entire reason we made another album. That was the only reason, really.
I've never seen you care about anything more than you cared about that.
If only we can get to be a wedding band. That's actually our ultimate goal, is if we could just be a wedding band. Yeah, yeah, that's all we want in life.
Well, what a segue for me to go to Sean here. Sean, we have a mic for you. I don't know if you knew that. Oh, sorry.
Throw it at him.
I know. Sorry. Mark, when an album drops, normally that day the band is nervous. Maybe they're celebrating, doing promotion. What happened with a wedding that day? How did that come about?
Well, the bride had hit us up, and she let us know that she was a really big fan of our band and that she happened to be getting married on the release date of 152. So we're like, well, that's really amazing. Our manager, Jillian, got in touch with the maid of honor and said, hey, these guys are going to be rehearsing about 2 hours away. We might be able to make something cool happen. And we just did. It was very serendipitous, and we got there, and we hung out and met the wedding party. They couldn't have been nicer. And then we marched out there, and John and Adam and Nathan played some songs, and it was just an amazing moment. Oh, the crowd was cheering for us. We had no idea if anyone would even know who we were. And, oh, my God, it was a really, really amazing moment, and I was so grateful to be a part of that.
Nice. All right, now we're coming back to you, Mark. Sorry. Here you go.
Thank you.
Hi. You've played a few new songs so far tonight.
Yeah.
How easy or difficult is it to get in the groove of the new stuff and it's time to go and there's cameras and there's people here and it's super intimate?
I'm overplaying. I'm playing too hard because I'm excited and I need to chill. And I keep on telling myself, yo, easy. But
yes, you got this. There ain't but one Mark O'Connell, baby.
Not playing hard. But man, the new songs are exciting to play. So it's fun.
Just sitting next to you, I'm seeing your arms, and I know my arms, and I'm not feeling good about myself.
Oh, man.
You look incredible.
You know, my shirt is a little tight.
It's your arms that
it's
are tight.
It's my shirt.
No, Adam, no. One more thing before we get to some more music. The first time hearing yourself on the radio, what was that experience like?
Oh, God, terrifying. But it was also, so it was terrifying, and it was just like in that movie.
That Thing You Do?
Yes, thank you. Yeah. That Thing You Do. Yeah. Yeah, with Tom Hanks, he's an American treasure. You know Tom Hanks,
right? Yeah, of course.
So,
the O'Neaters.
Yeah, yes. So, but like, if it like felt like we were, I don't remember. Like, we were driving. I think like it was in the car, and you just think somebody made like a real big mistake in your favor, like Monopoly bank error. You know, collect $50.
And John, we'll go to you and then get to some music. What do you want people to take away? Give me one sentence after listening to the 10 new songs.
That it's their favorite record that they've ever heard in their life.
That's a good one. You ready for more music, everybody? John, Adam, Sean, Mark, appreciate you guys being here tonight. The album, of course, is called 152. If you're listening on the app right now, we have one more song left for you. So this is what you should do. Go to the YouTube channel, and you can see all of our pretty faces right now. We got like 30 more minutes of music. YouTube.com/iHeartRadio. Again, I am Stryker. Thank you guys so much. Let the music continue. Here they are, Taking Back Sunday.
Sick is called, but don't bother it, so I know exactly what goes on. With everything you're getting, everything that you want, it brings it. My finger on the trigger. To explain, I know exactly when you're home. So how about I'm outside of your window?
How about I'm outside of your window?
Why did it keep all the details covered?
The lights and how bright it is in here, I can't help but be reminded of my the kitchen in my parents' house. Because it was always bright. We had this black, like, reflective refrigerator. It wasn't made that way. My dad went and cut it up, made it look beautiful from my memory. But it was the only full-length mirror we had in the house, right? And so what do? You put on some Operation Ivy and you dance in front of that refrigerator. That's what you do. And it's exactly like this.
There was also always 300 people in your kitchen.
Yeah.
Similar in that way, too.
That's why I say it was exactly like this. In my mind, there were 300 people.
That's right.
I think they're still up there, to be honest.
In your head.
Yeah, they make me stronger.
Mind.
I'm like a tiger.
What is that, Katy Perry?
I think so.
Baby, you're a firework.
Just one, though.
Just one firework.
Not singular.
Nope.
You ever thought
fireworks.
About that? You're welcome.
One firework. You are like one firework.
One fire. Oh, that was nice. All right, let's go. This song is called You Can't Look Back, and here's how we play it. I was living day to day, as the meetings they would suggest. Sitting pretty, having one foot out that door. Well, I didn't know how to act. Started running and I didn't look back. Still feel the same way, still don't know where I'm going. Oh, and then you left me. Don't know how you did it other than you did. Girl, you wish you could get you some. It'll work if you don't look big. Fuck a ticket, now you're on the track. You're cute, you can't look back. Can't look back. You cute, but you can't look back. Yeah. You cute, but you can't look back. I didn't know what I was looking for, and come to think I wasn't looking at all. I'm not the same man, not since you came in. I'm gonna get you if it takes me all night long. I'm gonna get you if it takes me all night long. I'm gonna get you if it takes me all night long. Takes me all night long.
I'm not the same man, not since he came in.
Gonna get you if it takes me all night. Gonna get you if it takes me all night long. I've seen it both states away. Your mama's calling from the other end. Someday a woman really needs you.
Oh,
what's gonna happen with the old man goes? Will you embrace chaos or take control? Once I've thrown outside your door, will you call for peace and enjoy no one? What you gonna do when the law breaks in? Will you stand your ground or confess your sins? Oh, no, you don't know. Will this weight get the weight is strong? Will you go when you can't go on? What's gonna happen on your dying day? Turn the dirt of my man, turn the pain. Oh, no, 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 you don't know it. Oh, no, 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 you don't know it. You can beg, you can plead, you can cry, you can pray. Nothing's gonna save you from the tidal wave. What's gonna happen when the old man goes? What's gonna happen when the old man goes? With the guns I've drawn outside your door, what's gonna happen when the old man goes? What you gonna do when the law breaks in? What you gonna do when the law breaks in? No, 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 you don't know it. No, 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 you don't know it.
So this, they told us we can play a couple more songs, and we were going to start off by playing you a song probably none of you have heard before. Woo! But don't worry, it'll be fine. We're driving, we'll get you there.
You're winning, that don't mean you got nothing to lose. I saw you walking down that real human teeth, a mouth full of promises, no guarantees. Say it's all over now, put on the bridge. Say what's done is done, you don't know what you did. Say it's all over now, put on the bridge. I know what you did. Trying to tell you the truth, preach to the choir, never felt so fucking good. It's all over now, cause I'm alone in the room. The problem isn't that I changed, the problem is that you stayed safe. The problem is that you stayed the same. You bootstrapping, bloodletting.
I'm having a fantastic time. I would like to thank all of you for taking time out of your lives to be here. This is just great. I wasn't aware that it was like this. And then so I walked in and I was like, oh. But I knew you all were gonna be here and that helped because I thought, well, maybe they've seen us before. So anyways, thank you very much for being here. This has been fantastic. We're going to play two more songs for you.
Two more songs.
And definitely not anymore. Union rules. Which I'm into. I think that's great. No, hey, man, listen. It's a great tune, man, their record. Yo, aren't you bummed there's not more like alien shit, though? I am.
There should have been a song called
that. Dude, I saw
Tom. About the aliens, motherfuckers.
Oh, man. We were joking about that the other day, and then, because we've all been such huge fans of that band, of Blink-182, and they also put out a new record. And if it wasn't for them, man, they took us out, like, early on. Like, there's those guys. I had their poster on my wall. John and I shared a bedroom, and he looked at the three of them in their underwear every morning when he woke up. Well, four, because I was there.
That's true. It was a very sexy time.
It was the best of times. It was the sexiest of times. No, it's not about that. Different strokes for different folks. You gotta understand, see? Mm-hmm.
And that's what I was doing after I looked at that poster.
Only when he thought I was sleeping.
That's right. Thought is the key word.
I wasn't ever sleeping. That's gross. Oh, ugh. Well, I mean, not if it, just to think that.
They get it.
Just like digging a hole up here. It's like, hold on, guys.
You're not saying, you're just saying.
No, I just mean, because that would, actually, if that was what you're doing, I'd probably be like, well, just cut it out, man. That's weird.
Do you want me to shine a light on this Blink-182 poster to help you out?
Here. All right.
What happened?
I know. No, I'm. Thank you for saying that. Thanks, man. Warped Tour was a good time. I remember this one time. I probably shouldn't tell this. This song's called Lightbringer. Try not to think
talk about it, cause you don't know what to call it when those banshees in your head come into collect. 5 o'clock round dinner, dancing in the mirror, caught him kissing on the tail end of the truck. You were happy once. Where am I making it all up? Am I making it all up? Am I making it, making it, making it up? Oh, you wore your hair back then, not sure how, had to be skin tight. Where's that line? I can't remember where we crossed that line. Oh, it's just like you said. Hell is what you're gonna get. Thinking only about you all night. How could you not have been in love? How could you not have been in love? Or am I making it all up? Am I making it, making it, making it up? Where's that light? I can't remember when we crossed that line.
Told us about you had left that, play that one.
Continue to play the set list.
It's right there. You read too.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all for being here. Again, thank you to iHeart Radio for having us. This is great. Stryker, thank you. This is a song that I realized in a conversation, because here's like how fucking wacky our lives are, right? And so I'm on the phone with Us Weekly, because that's just the thing you do on Tuesdays, you know? And they're like, can you tell us a story about an older song? You know? And then like we're like going through the list, I'm telling these stories, and then we got to this song, and then I was like, you know what, come to think about it, I 100% stole that from Star Wars. And I didn't even realize it till all these years later.
I can't believe you're just realizing that now.
First yeah,
time I
can't
I heard
either.
The song, I was like, oh, Star Wars.
That's why I like you, John. Because everything you do is lickety-splitly.
Well, yeah.
Just like Mr. Waite said.
Except when I'm lollygagging.
Yeah, that's true. Though he's got his swagger when he lollies before he gags, you see. That sounded so dirty, and I didn't mean it that way. I'm like, well, these are words that are coming out of my mouth. No stopping them now.
It's happening.
Oh, boy.
That's much how I feel when I'm lollygagging.
Hope nobody's judging me. No, I'm just kidding. I wouldn't give a shit. Except for late at night alone. While I'm scrolling the internet, realizing I have a problem.
with the internet.
Who doesn't?
I mean, it's not bad. It's just too much of anything's a bad thing.
That's right.
All right, good talk, everybody. Thanks for coming out. We're back on Take It Back Sunday. Thank you. Thank you for being here. This has been fantastic. This is, like I said, it was the first time we've had the opportunity to share a lot of those songs with anybody. So thank you for being the first. We'll never forget you.
Hope we were gentle.
Such small, sweet, so delicate. We used to be this diamond.
I got a bad feeling about this. I got a bad feeling about this.
Kept stealing to the long drive on. You slept safe and close to the window.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Oh, I got a bad feeling. Who's to say? Small, short, porcelain. Your skin out comes on my nerve, it's red. When it comes to this,
but it never was enough. I thought it knew when my world swings out the day to day.
I could have been
you about this. Coming over, but it never was enough. I thought it knew when my world swings out the day to day.